The devastated family of a toddler who vanished without a trace from a rural property are convinced he was abducted as police desperately search for the missing child, seizing a white Toyota and CCTV from a service station. Anthony A.J. Alfalik, 3, was with his family as they were getting ready for lunch on Friday morning at their 256 hectares rural property in Putty, about 150 kilometers northwest of Sydney in the Upper Hunter. AJ, who has autism and is nonverbal, was last seen playing on the porch, with his mother saying he was out of her sight for just a matter of seconds. His mother Kelly insisted AJ is not a wanderer and never leaves her side, with his father Anthony adding a kid doesn't just up and disappear. In a worrying development on Sunday, with police still scouring the area for clues, a white Toyota from a nearby property was taken by police as they searched an abandoned shack. Police also seized CCTV footage from the Colo Heights service station, which is a 40-minute drive south from Putty in the direction of Sydney, declaring it a site of interest. "I'm his universe. He holds my hand, all day and all night we are together," the boy's mother told The Australian. She and the boy's father joined the large search party, including police divers, the riot squad, trail bikes, drones and mounted officers, who were searching for the toddler over the weekend. His family even brought in a private helicopter to scour the area as police launched Strike Force Jailang to investigate the circumstances of AJ's disappearance. "He's been taken. If he was around here, I would have found him by now," Ms. Alfalik said. "I have searched the property. I'm still driving around and I cannot find him. If he was here, he'd be close to the property." Despite a search party being set up 10 minutes after AJ went missing, with four vehicles soon covering a large radius around the farm, he was nowhere to be found. Ms. Alfalik also said she noticed a suspicious white Toyota driving away from her house in the minutes after AJ vanished. "I saw it, it was driving really slowly, I thought it was my neighbor's," Ms. Alfalik told the Daily Telegraph. "He's not a wanderer. He never leaves my side." She was in the kitchen as AJ played on the porch, while his father was nearby in the yard fixing the chain on his quad bike. AJ was dressed in a grey top and pants with sneakers and is described as being of Mediterranean or Middle Eastern appearance, with short brown hair. Officers on Sunday were seen talking to one of AJ's older brothers. He has three brothers, Michael, Patrick and Alexander, in a paddock near the house, with one of the young boys taking detectives on a reenactment of his brother's disappearance. Alan Hassam, a neighbor and family friend who was helping Mr. Alfalik fix his bike, also said he spotted the Toyota. He also described the little boy's disappearance as out of character, saying he had never wandered off before. The neighbor recalled hearing AJ's mother raise the alarm and then stood up and spotted the vehicle, a white 1987 dual cab Toyota Hilux Toyota, driving down the road to the property. He said the Toyota drove along Yango Drive, 100 meters from the family's house, before going out to Putty Road, something he found unusual. "We didn't see it enter. We see every car that enters because it's a dead end. Something's not right. Something doesn't stack up," he added. On Sunday evening, police seized a white Toyota from a property about 1 kilometer south of the Alfalik house, labeling the car a vehicle of interest. Pictures from the abandoned property show a dingy shack fitted out with old furniture, with the floors strewn with rubbish. Police cordoned off the area and are trying to ascertain if anyone had been staying there as part of their investigation, with Nine News reporting it had been declared a crime scene. They have also seized a number of items from the property, amid reports someone had been sleeping rough there. CCTV was also pulled on Friday from a service station at Colo Heights, 45 kilometers away towards Sydney, which has been similarly labeled a site of interest. 15 dams on the property are a focus of the search, with one being drained on Sunday morning. "It's very stressful, a kid just doesn't pick up and disappear," AJ's father Anthony told Nine News. "Not from here, not from these parts. We're not doing too well," he added. Despite the desperation of the nearly three-day-long hunt, officials have asked the public to stay at home to avoid breaking COVID restrictions. Police are absolutely looking into every angle possible in relation to AJ's disappearance, Superintendent Tracy Chapman said. Obviously, our focus is very much around the search and trying to locate AJ. Searchers hit the ground this morning with over 130 actively searching this large property. The terrain is very difficult. We're in a rural setting, there are various levels of elevation. We have been searching some of the dams and waterways. NSW police said in a statement public assistance is not required in the search for the young boy and reminded people that COVID public health order restrictions still apply in the region. Anyone with information is urged to contact Crime Stoppers. Search crews are set to continue on Monday.